All right, class. Hey, so I just want to kind of clarify, man, you guys are not really doing well on your robot map. You're supposed to take measuring tape and literally measure out a map around the classroom that you would like your robot to travel on. It's got to be realistic. So just take a measuring tape and map out a certain path like I did here using these foam boards. So you take a measuring tape, you know, you decide, hey, I want to map something out. So let's say you're over here, and maybe you want to start your, this measuring tape's not very good. It's a little cheap, but maybe you want to start over here, and you want your robot to travel from this corner all the way, you know, onto the linear path, right? Because these are linear paths. Let's say you want to come all the way this way. You measure it out. So you say, get to this corner right here. You can't see me, but I'll move this video right over here. Right down in here. So this measures out about 23 feet. So that's 23 feet. So I would start my first path, 23 feet. I would sketch it out on paper. Straight line, boom, 23 feet. Where do I want my robot to go after that? Well, if I want it to come this way, through this door, and I would say, okay, maybe I'm working with a teammate, and I take my measuring tape again and draw that out. You know, to this door here, maybe I want to go in this other room. This looks like it's about 8 feet. So my first drawing, if I was going to draw it on Onshape, this is just a sketch here. Here I am. Let's say I have my marker here. So I was coming this way, 24 feet, and then I actually went in this direction, 8 feet. At a right angle, right? And then I would continue to draw that path out on shape. Again, like I said, the path that I'm drawing, I wanted you to sweep a particular shape on that path. And then from that sweep, then you go into the drawing template, the drawing tab, and then create a front view of your model. And I explain that. So I'm gonna show that next, okay? So I've got this L shape, 24 feet by 8 feet, and I put inches, sorry. And I'm gonna back this up with an Onshape video, modeling this 24 by 8, if that's my map, okay? Hope this helps. Look, class, take a look at the SpeedBot map. So like I showed in the previous video, showing how to measure out the classroom, what you're going to do is take a sketch. Front view is fine. Start off by taking a segment, drawing your path. We said that was going to be 24 inches. I think the video said 23 feet. So I'll just start there, move down this way, and let's dimension that out. It may have been 23 feet. Or 24 feet. Now you notice I'm in millimeters, so I should modify that, but I'll type in feet. Let's see if it works here. Yeah, it does. So you could scale it by utilizing feet. I'm in millimeters, so it converted feet to millimeters. I can adjust that here. So if you go to document properties and cancel that, and let's see. Document workspace units. There we go. So we want to change that to feet for now. Okay, let's see if that helps. Yeah, so that's 24 feet.
Any teacher with a sixth period prep, here, please dial extension 2363. If you have a sixth period prep, please dial extension.
Sorry about that audio. Here, this is going to be 8 feet. And there you have it. So that was the path that I mapped out in the classroom. Select that. Now what I want to do is create a plane on the starting point. So it's called curve and point. I'm going to create one. So let's create the curve. It's the curve. And then let's pick the point. And let's see if you can draw it out. Well, it's actually the way I designed it. That would just be the right plane. So I don't need to do that. Too much info. I could just create another sketch on the right plane. And there you go. So that's perfect. You want it to be perpendicular to your sketch. And now I'll draw a rectangle center point. And it's going to be 2 feet by 2 feet. And the reason why it's 2 feet by 2 feet is because the pads, foam pads, are 2 feet by 2 feet. There you go. And that's what we want. Perfect. Let's go to the sweep option. New. Let's pick our face or region that we're going to sweep. Click on the sweep path. Accept it. Now let's create a drawing based on that 3D model. Create a drawing. Custom template. Actually, no, not a custom template. Owned by me, that is. Owned by me. And wow, that's not there. I have a couple of templates here. And my title block is not there. I wonder why. Created by me. There we go. Created by me. Not owned by me, but created by me. There it is. Custom title block right there. That's it. It's also here too as well. Either one will work fine. So let's insert this part. Now it's 100:1. Okay, so if you click on this again, left click twice, let's change this to 50:1. There you go. Then what you want to do is you want to add some dimensions to your shape here. So this, again, looks like it's in some type of scale that I don't want. I want it to be in feet. Refresh the browser here. It's one issue with the. So on the drawing template, everything is measured in inches. How do I know? On the right side here, you have that wrench settings. The units are in inches. And that's fine. So I'll leave it in inches for now. The decimal place value is 3 decimal places. I'll just go. Tons of interruptions. What I'll do is I'll just go to the nearest single decimal place, maybe 2. So let's go back here. Inches is fine, and the precision for that is just 2 decimal places. Okay, so let's measure this out, which is what you should do. A lot of you didn't do this. That's 300 inches. This is 276, and the thickness here is 24 inches. Here to here, we've got 108. So that's what I'm expecting. The dimensions in inches, something that tells me what scale you're using, and then don't forget to fill out the information in the correct title block. Alrighty, like I always say, study hard, learn a lot, and we'll see you soon. Bye-bye.